animals are in shelters because people just don't want them anymore, or people find them on the streets and bring them in. And homeless animals outnumber homeless people about 5 to 1. And the speech over my experience while volunteering at the Little Rock Animal Village might affect you by connecting to your emotions and making you urge to adopt an animal. My name is Lauren Cox. I'm a speech communication student, and I volunteered 5 hours at the Little Rock Animal Shelter. Today I'm going to tell you about my service learning experience at the Little Rock Animal Village. During my speech, I will talk about my service learning experience at the LRAV, and then what my experience entailed. I'll also go into depth over communication concept, principles, civil and ethical implications, all relating back to the Little Rock Animal Village and helping give these animals a second chance. And now this dashing little boy over here is Mr. Wayland. I actually adopted him from the Little Rock Animal Village a little over a year ago, so that urged me to go back and volunteer there. He actually dealt with some anxiety issues because he was abused, and we worked with him, but now every time we leave him alone, he'll tear anything aside, like the wall, your foiler seat. He'll take a big chunk out of the couch, don't think about it. Okay. I completed my service hours at the Lark Animal Village. Volunteering at the animal shelter can help make dogs and cats more accustomed to home life than what they eventually adopted. The Little Rock Animal Shelter's mission is to construct a better village, adopt ratings, public safety, and saving animals' lives, of course. So my experience there were the people. They were all nice, friendly. I actually got to work with a lot of other volunteers there. There's usually about 5 to 10 there a day. Only a day. The place is very clean, friendly, and loud. My tasks were providing TLC for the dogs, going outside, walking them, bathing them, everything. They actually have volunteer classes if you'd like to do that. How I helped was exercise, social, go outside, play with them, and rehabilitate them. It's exactly what in their cage they have little stickers that say they need to socialize with. Well, that means you take them outside and actually spend bonding time with them so they get more used to a human touch, like Wayland. Some people there, I actually took my brother there, and he's a little scrawny guy that likes big dogs, so he got drug around a lot. And then Skip was the volunteer director, like he said. Skip reminds you of Santa Claus. He has that thin tail. He's really nice and friendly, just like everyone else there. Okay, when I took the dogs outside, they always felt really good about it. They learned socialization skills and helped them become friendly and hopefully get adopted that way. Playing with the cats and everyone, it helped give them exercise and fresh air as well. Now that I have told you more about the animal village and what I did there, let me explain the communication concepts and principles that go along with the experience. And that's awesome compared to his big dogs. There are two communication concepts and communication principles connected to my service experience. There are many valid reasons to why you should take my speech to heart, only because dogs are animals' best friend. Dogs are man's best friend, sorry. And you can become a companion forever. They never fail to give us love, and so why can't we give them the love they need back? My first communication concept is appreciative listening. The definition, according to Lane Abigail Fuchs, 2014, is a type of listening in which engaged we want to enjoy and appreciate the message we listen to. An example of my experience of this, what illustrates the concept, is listening to the animals, such as if they are whining, or so you would know to get them out and play with them in the yard. My example illustrates the definition because I listened to how the dogs were affected, and according to how they were sounding is how it needed to give them affection. My second communication concept is comprehensive listening, learning. According to Lane Abigail Gooch, 2014, a type of listening in which we engage when we want to learn, understand, and recall information. An example from my service that illustrates this concept is I use the communication concept and comprehensive learning by listening to my supervisor, Skip, when he taught me how to properly volunteer. We went over what to do and what not to do and what I was not allowed to do. The example illustrates the definition because I listened and engaged to my supervisor, Skip, what he had told me, and he helped me learn how to properly perform certain tasks. The relevant communication principle is messages are adapted in different ways to achieve similar results. The definition, according to the URLR Survival Guide 2017, is there are many different ways to achieve particular outcomes. The symbolic nature of adapted one's message and communicating various of different people. An example of my service that illustrated the principle is being a unique communicator when I volunteered. I took pictures, uploaded them to Facebook to get the word out, and I actually had a lot of people go up there and look at the dogs, and I actually got two dogs adopted that way. So they kept wanting me to keep doing that. My example illustrates the principle because I took different approaches to help get the word out for the animals. Now that I have told you about my communication concepts and communication principles connected to my service experience, let me explain the communication concepts and civil ethical implications I can relate to my service experience as well. Based on the service experience, I can use the communicate concepts and civil ethical implications to improve my communication and help improve my communication. My audience should care about what I'm facing to say because they can understand how I should improve in certain communication concepts so they can get a better understanding and how they could improve theirs as well. One communication concept I could use to improve my communication would be confirming responses. The definition, according to Lane Abigail Gooch, 2014, is a civil, verbal, and nonverbal communication that experiences affection, respect, and concern. I chose this concept based on my experience because I felt like I did a good job in showing affection to the animals. I can use this concept to improve my communication by having a better sense of what others in general are feeling, not just the animals. So in conclusion, today I told you about my service learning at the Little Rock Animal Village. During my speech, I told you about my experience volunteering at the Little Rock Animal Village. I described the atmosphere, responsibilities, and people I worked with. I mentioned two communication concepts and a communication principle connected to my service experience. Then based on my experience, I tied it in communication concepts, civil ethical implications to improve my communication that would help my community. By adopting animals, you're giving them a second chance at life, but maybe they can help yours as well.